A simple but effective way to run a macro is with the help of form controls and specifically buttons. How can we do that? You place a button on the ribbon and then assign a macro to it. When the button is clicked, the macro is executed. The most common use of macros is in navigation. In the following example, you will create a quick and easy way to see the same data on different charts. In this worksheet, I have a data table with project sales from the year 2010 to the year 2014. Also, I have a cluster column chart right below the data table. You will create two macros, one for column chart and one for bar chart. Let's get started. Press this button to start recording. Name it to chart 1. And store it in this workbook. Nice. Highlight the chart. Now go to Design tab and click on Change Chart Type. Select Column Chart and OK. Stop recording the macro. Let's do the same steps for the second macro and start recording again. Name it to chart 2 and store it in this workbook. Highlight the chart, go to Design tab and click on Change Chart Type. Select Bar Chart and OK. Stop recording the macro. The final step is to design our buttons. On the Developer tab, click the Insert command. In the drop-down list that appears, select the button form control. When you drop the button control on your spreadsheet, the Assign Macro dialog box appears. Select the macro chart 1 and then click OK. Let's do exactly the same for the second button. Great! If you want, you can do some formatting, like added text to the buttons. Test them. And as you can see, they work great. Recording specific actions enables you to manage risk because your users will interact with your reports in a method that you developed and tested. So we managed to automate simple reporting tasks using macros and buttons. Thanks for watching.